Happiness.
Dukkha.
Dukkha. I'm paying.
Campaign.
The giving.
Giving.
Agama.
Agama.
Appearing.
Appearing.
Apaino.
Apaino.
Disappear.
Disappear.
Anitya.
Anitya.
Non-permanent.
Non-permanent.
Tan.
Tan.
All of them.
All of them.
Titikshasva.
Titikshasva.
Just try to tolerate.
Just try to tolerate.
Bharata.
Bharata.
O descendant.
O descendant.
Of the Bharata dynasty.
Of the Bharata dynasty.
Timarandasya Jananjana Salakaya Chakshuramilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovesta Sabitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Tadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata Pada Kamalam Shri Gurun Vaishnavamsa Shri Rupam Sarajatam Sahagana Raghuna Tangitam Tam Sashivam Sarvaitam Sarvadutam Harishana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Pada Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakha Nikamsha Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanda Radha Kanda Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Krishna Panu Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kaupata Rubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Yare Vacha Pajita Nam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Nama Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadi Gaurabhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So this is a very nice verse. This describes to us how we should understand happiness and distress. We have to understand that both happiness and distress are temporary, they're not eternal. Bashman, sit properly. Where are you going? So they are compared, happiness and distress are compared to the winter and to the summer. Just like if you go to a western country like England. So in London, in the winter time it's very cold. Very wet and windy. Never see the sun. Remember when we went to see London in Terminal 21? I was telling you what Prabhupada said about hell. What did Prabhupada say? Who remembers? Not one boy remembers. Everything goes in one ear and out the other ear, eh? London what? London is a hell. Why?
Because
it's very cold.
Very cold? Why is it very cold?
No sun.
Why is there no sun?
Where's
the sun? The sun is there every day.
Cannot see because it's winter season.
Because it's winter, right? Winter, and there are many clouds. You can't see the sun because of the clouds. Right? So, but winter does not last forever. Just like now in Thailand, it's very hot. But it does not stay hot forever. Sometimes it will rain. Maybe. So when it's very hot, or when it's very cold, then we feel, feel very cold, very cold. Or you feel very hot, very hot, very uncomfortable. If it's very cold at night, in the winter, it's very cold, you need blankets to keep warm. And in the summer here, if we give you blanket, then you'll feel too hot. So if you have to go in the kitchen and cook in the summer, is it very nice? Just like Chandra Banu's mother is running a restaurant in Krabi. and she's cooking and she's baking cake. Many cake. She's a good baker. But the oven is very hot. You all like the cake when we had the cake, right? But you didn't have to make that cake. If you have to go and put it in the oven, and then you have to go to the oven very hot, then it's not very nice, because now weather also very hot, the oven become more hot. If you have to go and cook on the hot stove, you have to cook, you have to stir very hot, and the pot is hot, and the fire is hot, and you're cooking, sweating, or... When you eat, you don't think about how much trouble the person has to go to do the cooking. So maybe tomorrow we will just give you salad to eat. Everything raw. Okay, that's very good.
Okay,
so to cook, to have to cook in the summer, it's not very nice. It's very difficult. And to take bath in the summer, very nice. Because we're so hot, we're so sweaty, so we take a bath, oh, very nice. But if we take you to England to take a bath in the winter, no hot water. The water very cold. Like in Burma. Mohan knows from Burma. In the winter, in December, very cold, eh? Did you take a bath in the cold water? Huh? Is it very nice? So sometimes, all right. You want to give the class? So we have to learn to tolerate these difficult conditions.
If Sumaduri says, oh, now it's too hot, I'm not going to cook tomorrow, it's too hot. Oh, then that would be a problem, huh? What will we eat? Well, we'll just drink water.
You go to 7-Eleven.
Because you are nonsense. Because you are kiki. You are kiki at das. No, we have to tolerate the heat. And we tolerate also the cold. Devotee means tolerant. Have to be tolerant about happiness and distress. Happiness and distress will come just like the winter and the summer. We have to learn to be tolerant. Lord Chaitanya said, be tolerant like a tree. Just like the tree tolerates. Amrit. Prakapi. Banditi. The tree tolerates the heat of the sun and the cold and the wind. But the tree is so kind. They give flowers, they give fruit. Sometimes even we cut the tree still grows again. And the tree gives shelter sometimes, it will protect us from the heat of the sun. When we go in the park in the morning, we go to that park, there's so many trees, it's very nice smell. The trees are so kind. We have to be, Lord Chaitanya said, be tolerant like the tree. In the Shikshastika, we say every morning Lord Chaitanya's words. So Lord Chaitanya said, Trinadapi
Sushmishena Prabhupakshita Ishuna Amina Mandela Kirtaniya Sadahari.
Come play. One should be more tolerant than the tree, devoid of all sense of false prestige, ready to offer all respects to others, and not want respect for himself. In such a state of mind, one can chant the holy name constantly.
สามารถสวดภาวนาพระนามได้อย่างตลอดรอดฝั่ง
telling Arjuna, you should not be just worried about being happy. Sometimes there will also be distress. When you are happy, what should we do? We should thank Krishna. We should think Krishna is just encouraging me. I'm not a very good person, but Krishna just wants to encourage me.
And
when we are in distress, what should we think? Then we have to also thank Krishna. We should think, I'm such a bad person, Krishna should punish me more, but he's only giving me a little punishment. So we cannot expect every day there will be happiness. We cannot expect every day distress. When we get happiness, then after happiness, then there will come distress. And then after the distress, then the happiness will come. Just like after the winter comes the summer, and after the summer, then comes the winter again. We have to learn to be tolerant. It's a very important quality of a devotee. Just like sometimes you have to tolerate. There's not enough prasada. What to do? Oh, I wanted more prasadam. Prasadam is finished. What do we say? Thank you, Krishna. And when the prasadam is too much, then what do you say?
Thank you, Krishna.
But when there's too much prasadam, doesn't mean you have to eat too much. Not like some people, some devotees will eat too much, right, Amrit? And then they vomit. So we have to learn to control our mind. What one day we are happy, that's the mind. Another day we're in distress, it's the mind. Don't be disturbed. How to tolerate? What do we need to do if we want to tolerate? We need to chant Hare Krishna. Yeah, chant loud. If we chant loud, then we'll forget about all the pain and suffering. Just like Haridas Thakur, he was taken in the marketplace and they were beating him with a whip. He It took him in 22 marketplaces. They were beating him. What was he doing? Yeah, he was chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna
Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Because he's chanting Hare Krishna, Mohan. Because he's chanting Hare Krishna, he did not feel any pain or any problem. So we have to learn how to take shelter of the holy name. We have to do everything, we have to do our duty, we have to do it for Krishna. Just like sometimes we go for Sankirtan, sometimes we will go for Harinam Sankirtan. And sometimes the people will be very nice. And sometimes the people will be very nasty. Sometimes you go in the marketplace chanting Hare Krishna and they will throw the tomato at you. Yeah, they will throw a very soft and when it hit you, then it burst and all the tomato juice go all over you. So should you get angry?
No.
What should you do?
Hare Krishna.
Keep chanting. Sometimes we go for book distribution. Alright. Sometimes we go for the book distribution and we offer the book to someone and they take the book. What should we do? Should we fight him? Devotee means to be tolerant. What? Be like the tree. Just like people come and they cut down the tree, they cut the tree just tolerates. They cut the tree, the tree grows again. But we have to learn from the tree. Some trees, they have poison. So there's a nice story. One man, there's a story, everyone listen, Panditi. There's a one scorpion. You know scorpion?
Yeah.
In Koh Samui, very big scorpion. I saw a big one. Whoa. Can bite. If they bite you, very painful.
Yeah.
So the man saw the scorpion drowning in the water. So he picked it up out of the water. But when he picked it up from the water, it bit him. So when it bit him, it went, ah! And so he dropped it, it fell back in the water. So he picked it up again. He picked it up again from the water. But when he picked it from the water, it bit him again. Again he fell back in the water. So he went to pick it up again. So his friend said to him, he said, why you bother? He said, the thing keep biting you, why you take so much trouble to try to save it? But the man said, no, he said, the scorpion, he does not stop trying to bite me. Why I should stop trying to save him? The scorpion's nature is to bite. But I'm devotee. Devotee's nature is to try to save others. So we should always remember to be kind on the fallen souls. If somebody does something wrong, we shouldn't get angry at them, we should be tolerant. We should tell them. You should become devotee of Krishna. Now Mahatma Gandhi, he said, we should, there was a saying. That an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Do you know that saying? If somebody does something bad to you, you should do something bad to them. You should get revenge back. If somebody knocks out one of your teeth, then you want to knock out one of their teeth. If somebody punch one of your eyes, then you want to punch their eye. So if we follow that, this is not good. This is not the good way to live. We are devotee. Devotee should not be like that. If we do that, then everybody will be blind and nobody will have anything. Yeah, do you like that? Will we all be blind? We'll knock out everybody's teeth, each other's teeth. So we have to learn to be tolerant. And to do that, we have to chant Hare Krishna. Your mouth is for chanting Hare Krishna.
ปากเราเนี่ยมีไว้ให้สวดอะไร
not for putting your hand in your mouth. Use your tongue to chant. Then you can be more tolerant. Okay, any question? Sandra, you have a question? No questions today? Anybody, any questions? Only question is, what's for Prasada, no? What do you say, Veda? How to answer? Even if we have to be violent. Well, Vamanadev, Lord Vamanadev didn't follow the order of the Master. If the order of the Master is against the principles of Scripture, then we don't follow. Don't just do everything a master tells you. We have to consider the circumstances. So in the case of Arjuna, his use of violence was justified. Because many sinful things had been done. They'd been very bad to Draupadi. And they'd taken all the property from the Pandavas. And they tried to kill the Pandavas in many ways. So the violence was justified. But ultimately, because Krishna wanted the violence, that was the most important thing. Because Krishna is not just only spiritual master, Krishna is the Supreme Lord. And he was directly telling them. But Krishna wanted to establish the devotees on the throne.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki, Srila Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki.